Okay, good afternoon, everybody. All of you can hear me?
Yes, sir. Good afternoon, sir.
Okay. I want to start discussing your doubts from past year mains questions from tomorrow. Okay. Maybe you may be trying per day 15 questions because I'm starting a little late. I may discuss. Today, there are 3-4 questions left in the subjective questions are related to AP. We'll complete that. I'll tell theory about geometric progression, and we may do some questions on geometric progression depending on the time. Okay. Anyway, I kept a message in the group. I don't know, maybe by mistake some people joined there. I don't know. But my KVPY class is every day at 3:25. Monday and Thursday, I may take up to 4:30. Other days, I may take up to 4. Okay. Every day, I'm not going to send the link. Somebody can save that link for those who want to attend that. Sometimes, if NRs or Patnaik or somebody keeps a class during that time, then you want to watch later, I'm sending the link video. You can watch on that. Right. Okay. This is an arithmetic progression with mth term as 1 by n and nth term as 1 by m. Now they want to find sum of mn terms. So method 1, what is this? Mth term is a plus m minus 1 into d, which is 1 by n. And this is a plus n minus 1 into d, which is 1 by m. Two equations and two unknowns. When you solve, you will get A equal to 1 by mn. D is also 1 by mn. That's what you will get. Now, if you want sum of mn terms, it is n by 2 into 2a plus mn minus 1 into d. Here also not n, mn. What is A? 1 by mn. And what is D is also 1 by mn. So denominator is same, I can get mn plus 1. So I'll get mn into mn plus 1 by 2 mn. Or 2 mn will cancel. Then mn plus 1 by 2. Yeah. This mn you can cancel, you'll directly get mn plus 1 by 2. Nothing difficult, just simple routine question. But I also just, you may not need the second method that I'm telling. But I said, whenever you take n value and the corresponding term, all such terms are collinear. Okay. These kind of points where n belongs to natural number are collinear in AP. So if I take m comma 1 by n and n comma 1 by m and try to find the line equation passing through these two, I will get y is equal to x by mn. That is your line. If you want first term, put x equal to 1, we'll get 1 by mn. If you want second term, we'll get 2 by mn. Third term is 3 by mn, so on. Now you know A and common difference that way. Or if you want sum of mn terms, it will be 1 plus 2 plus 3, so on up to mn by mn. Okay. Basically, it is average. We already studied about statistics. Whenever numbers are an arithmetic progression, the average, sum of the numbers by total number, is first number plus last number by 2, which is 1 plus mn by 2. You can do like this or like this. Any question? Anybody want to tell a different method for anything? Please feel free. Whether it is easier than this or lengthier than this, you want to share, you are always welcome. Did NR sir say anything about starting physical classes?
Yes, sir. From Monday it was.
From this coming Monday itself.
Sir knows he is not convinced. He will first do trials in senior camp.
He'll start to trial online and offline.
Yeah. We started. Yeah, in Sankarmata campus, that is other seniors. Last 1 week we had done trials and today I took the class. Around 10 students came. It is a combined class because some sections we combined there. So we took that is a class of 45, around 84 students. Okay, in that 10 students turned up first day. So I just kept my camera to a tripod stand, the phone, okay, like this, and it just captures the video. And others I'll directly see that. Okay, they just purchase one tripod stand with a wife. Yes, please.
If anybody asks doubts, sir.
If they, they can ask, if they physically ask now, we'll just walk around and just clarify to them or on the board. Online,
yes, sir. Clarify physically on the board. Okay, sir. Online.
Online, though, we'll be able to hear the same setup. Phone is there, my this is there. Earphones are there.
Will be more from the others.
I don't find any much difference. For example, here, nobody is watching my class. Sometimes people are watching my class directly in my room. That's all. If those are sitting physically, if they ask some doubt, then also I'll teach on the board, okay, so that online people also can. Anyway, situation is we have to try to get best out of the situation. Whether this is best or not, that's different. But the situation, is it best or not?
Yes, sir. What's your review, sir?
My view is because some parents are persisting, some children, because they're not able to. Some children are not able to, they have some eye problems. They're not able to watch videos for a long time, genuinely. And some parents are not able to control their children. They said, if they go out of the house, we don't have any headaches. They want to send them out of the house. Okay. So because of this, some people want further only, they planned this. What is best according to my opinion? I don't know. Okay.
Sir?
Yes, please.
Sir, what is the timings of those classes, sir?
For them, online earlier, we were always teaching 4 hours, I said. For them, always 8:30 to 1 with an half an hour gap. Per day, 4 hours only. So, physical class is also same. But for you, I don't know what will happen because your timings have to change. And our sir now cannot take at 6:30 in the morning and all that.
Yes, sir, that only.
I don't know all those details. Okay. Maybe ASB, we can continue like this for at least a month. It may be better. Because class timings especially, otherwise not an issue. But anyway, anything is good. Okay, 11th question, ABCR first, third and nth terms. Prove that the sum to n terms of it is it a product or plus? We'll find our results. First, third and nth term. And they want sum of n terms. Okay, so T1 is A, T3 is B, Tn is C, they want to find Sn. That's the question basically. What is there? I can use first term plus last term. Only I have to know number of terms in terms of ABC, not in terms of n. They want this answer in terms of ABC without n. So I have to find only n in terms of A and B. So the common difference will be T3 minus T1 by 2. Okay. So, because third time minus first time common will gap will be 2D. So, that will be B minus A by 2. Now, coming to this C, which is equal to Tn, which is equal to A plus N minus 1 into common difference. How to find N from here? Let us substitute this and bring it down. Okay. So, C minus A by D is N minus 1. So I can bring one this side, I'll get, but I have to substitute what is D. D is B minus A by 2, okay. So C minus A by B minus A by 2 is N minus 1. That is 2 times C minus A by B minus A is N minus 1. If I bring 1 this side, what will happen? 2C minus 2A plus A will be minus 3A plus B by B minus A is N. Or maybe they were just want to keep it like this, we'll see. Maybe N, they want to write 2 into C minus A by B minus A plus 1. That is why they want to keep it like this one. Now, what is sum of N terms formula is N by 2 into 2A plus N minus 1 into D, or first term plus last term also we have. In the place of N by 2, I have to divide this with 2. I have to write C minus A by B minus A plus 1 by 2. T1 plus Tn, first term plus last term is A plus C. If the answer is like this or any difference? Yes, when I multiply these two C plus A, this is minus A square. This itself is answer. So when I multiply these two, it is C square minus A square by B minus A. When I multiply these two, it is C plus A by 2. Okay, so nothing much. Just to understand, sum of N terms answer should not contain N. Okay, so these two are known to us, but N is not known to us in terms of ABC. So we found done this. First, we found common difference in terms of AB. Next, we found N itself in terms of ABC. Okay, so you'd like to understand. If any doubt, you can ask me. Does it completed? You can read 13th question and try. Pavan, you are there, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so yes, sir. This I'm taking some KVPY classes where I discussed 2019 paper, 2018 paper, and now I'm discussing 2017 paper. You may not be writing KVPY now. I don't know how much time you have. Doesn't it focus on what is going on in your math, physics, chemistry tracks? If you still feel you have time, you can solve KVPY paper and listen to the video, or you can attend the class, up to you, your choice. Where the general division of other topics also will take place through the question.
Sir, actually KVPY is not applicable for droppers.
I know. What I said is not for the KVPY exam, just for learning the subject.
Okay, sir, I will attend.
Even if you want the previous class of 2019 and 18 paper, my videos are there in the YouTube. I can send my the channel link and you can see also if you want.
Okay, sir.
Okay. I'm going to erase. Anybody has any doubt or need more time? Okay, what is the 13th question? If odd positive integers are divided into the groups, that two also in odd numbers, 1, 3, 5, okay. Find the sum of the numbers in the nth group, okay. So, 1 and 3, 5, 7, and 9, 11, 13, 15 and 17. Okay. First of all, we are only writing odd numbers. Then we are grouping them according to 1 here, 3 here, 5 here, 7 here, 9 here. They are also odd numbers. Like that, the nth bracket or nth whatever it is group, what are the sum of the terms? That was the question. Before that, first of all, I think we all know 1 plus 3 plus 5 plus 7, so on up to 2n minus 1 is n square. Sum of first n odd natural numbers is n square. I think everybody knows this. Even if you use a regular AP formula also, same thing will come. N by 2 into first term plus last term will get n square. I wanted to make some videos, but there was no time. Okay, they are not like full-fledged making videos in the YouTube, not that type of profession. At least children in ninth class and all, it may be somewhat interesting. This is a total 16 squares. Okay, small squares I'm talking about. This is one square. These are three squares. These are five squares. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. These are seven squares. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So if you count the number of squares, one way directly it is 4 into 4, 16. But other way it is 1 plus 3 plus 5 plus 7. If I take a little bigger one, you will realize 1 plus 3 plus 5 plus 7, so on up to 2n minus 1 is n square. Okay. Actually, keeping these kind of things in mind, I kept the channel name Beautiful Math, not for the regular work. Because, you know, this is such a simple, beautiful proof. But I don't have time to make these videos. Okay, anyway, this is clear. Sum of n natural numbers is n square. Now, coming to this. I have to know my nth group, how many terms are there? What is the first term? What is the last term? Or something of that sort. Okay. So if I take number of terms in nth group, number of terms in nth group. Okay. Here one number is covered, here three numbers covered, here five numbers are covered. So in nth group, the number of numbers will be 2n minus 1. Because that is the nth term of 1, 3, 5, 7, so on. This many numbers will be there in the nth group. How to know the first term in the nth group? Okay, so I'm going to write number of odd numbers covered in n groups. First n groups. First group covered one odd number. Second group covered three odd numbers, next five, last one is 2n minus 1, which is n square. So up to nth group, how many odd numbers are covered? This many numbers are covered. So in nth group, what is the last number? Okay, so last element of nth group is n square th odd number. Okay. This many odd numbers are covered in the total n groups. So the last term of the nth group will be n square th odd number. Because this many odd numbers are covered, n square th odd number will be the last term in the nth group. But what is n square? Nth odd number will be 2n square minus 1. That is because nth odd number is 2n minus 1. Okay. Written all. Nth odd number is 2n minus 1. That is there already here. You know that. Okay. So like that, n square, nth odd number is 2n square minus 1. So now if I take only nth group, only nth group, what is the last term? 2n square minus 1. Anybody want to guess what the first term will be?
2n square plus 1. 2n minus 1 square plus 1.
Yeah, it will be 2 into n minus 1 whole square minus 1 plus 2. Okay. Why did I write that? This is the last term of nth group. What is the last term of n minus 1th group? Replace n with n minus 1. That is this. That is the previous group's last. But I have to add 2 for the next odd number. That is this plus 2. Okay. So in my nth group, I have, and these are total, how many numbers are these? 2n minus 1 numbers with a common difference 2. This is the first term. This is the last term. And this is the first term. In fact, I don't have to know this also, because I can take all these numbers are AP from reverse order also. I can take this as the first term, common difference minus 2, this many terms. I can treat AP like that also. Now, I don't have to start with first term. I can start with last term and take the common difference negative of that. Okay, so now I have to find this. So sum of these terms. Sometimes we are able to tell directly. I don't know here. We'll see that at the end after comes. Okay. So now the sum of all these terms will be 2n minus 1 by 2, n by 2 into first term plus last term. Even though I know common difference, I know this. So 2 into n minus 1 whole square plus 1 plus 2n square minus 1. Plus 1 minus 1 will go, 2 will go. I'll get 2n minus 1 into n minus 1 whole square plus n square. Actually, this minus this is this. So I've got n power 4 minus n power n minus 1 whole power 4 also. N power 4 minus n minus 1 whole power 4 also I've got. For example, this is 15, which is 2 power 4 minus 1 power 4. This is, what is this? 17 plus 9 is, directly what is the, how many pi numbers? Middle number is 13, 13 pi is 65. Is 65 is 3 power 4 minus, no, not 3 power 4. What is this render first 2 by the way? Nth group. So if I want third group, I want 3 power 4 minus 2 power 2, which is 81 minus 16. That is 65, yes, right? Okay, so you can write. If you know that this square minus this square is this, you can write it as n power 4 minus n minus 1 whole power 4. If you don't know that, you will just expand this, and if you multiply, I know binomial term for this, I'll write directly right answer, which is 4n cube minus 6n square minus plus 4n minus 1. Okay, so that's the answer. Or 2n minus 1 into something. I don't know what the answer is given in the book. Okay, please try to understand and first understand the question. If any doubt, I'm ready to explain the whole thing or a part of it.
Sir?
Yes, please.
Sir, can you explain again, sir, once?
I'll explain. Just take 2 minutes to understand. I'm looking for one book, physical problem. I want to see what the answer is. They just they give 2n minus 1 into 2n square minus 2n plus 1. This also answer, or you can write 2n minus 1 into 2n square minus 2n plus 1. This is what is given at the end of the book. All of it. Okay. First of all, the question is, you write all the odd numbers in order. First odd number you put in one group. Next three odd numbers put in another group. Next five odd numbers. Next seven odd numbers. Next nine. Next 11 odd numbers. Like that you make them into groups. Nth group, what is the sum of the terms? That's the question. So first of all, I wanted to know, starting from here up to nth group, how many numbers are written? Here one number is written, here three numbers are written, here five numbers are written. The nth bracket has 2n minus 1 numbers. The total, the sum is n square. So n square odd numbers are used up for writing first group to nth group. What is the number of terms in the nth group? Here one terms, here three terms, here five terms, next seven. So nth group has 2n minus 1 terms. Now I want to know total how many odd numbers are covered. Number of odd numbers or number of numbers covered in first n groups. Okay. I wrote here, why I wrote once again, I don't need this, right? Sorry. This and this are same only. Okay. Number of odd numbers covered in first n groups. Here one covered, here three covered, here five covered, nth group 2n minus 1 covered, and this sum is n square. So n square odd numbers are written. By the time you completed the n squareth number, you finish the nth group. Okay. But what is n squareth odd number? If this many odd numbers are covered, what the last odd number in your list? Nth odd number formula is 2n minus 1. Like that n squareth odd number is 2n square minus 1. So when you write brackets like this, the nth bracket, if you write, the last term is 2n square minus 1. If you take the previous bracket to this n minus 1th bracket, the last term would have been, wherever n is there, right, n minus 1, which is 2 into n minus 1 whole square plus 1. For this, the next odd number should be written here. So I have to add 2 to get this. This is minus 1. So this is the last term of nth group. This is the last term of n minus 1th group. Add 2, we'll get first term of n minus 1. Right? So this is the last term, this is the first term, and this many terms. Somehow they're all in AP with a common difference too. We know that sum of terms of this AP is normally total number of terms by 2 into first term plus last term. This is the first term, this is the last term, this many terms by 2. And you simplify this. Is it okay now?
Yes, sir.
Okay, I want to erase. Does anybody need more time to copy or to understand? Okay, so now we'll go into the theory of geometric progressions. Okay, so geometric progression. If you have some terms T1, T2, T3, and T4, T5, so on, the progression is such a way that T2 by T1 is same as T3 by T2, same as T4 by T3 and same as T5 by T4. So they're all equal. Every number by the previous number, if they're all equal, it's called GP or geometric progression. Okay. And that ratio is called common ratio. Generally, we represent it R. Of course, common ratio should not be zero. And first term also should not be zero. Basically, no term of a GP should be zero. Okay. So in between terms cannot be zero. if somebody takes by mistake common ratio is 0, it takes 7 and we keep on multiplying 0, we get 0, 0, 0, 0, 0. But we don't consider this as a GP, because in the definition itself, we tell common ratio should not be 0. Or you start with 0, let's say multiply 5, keep on multiplying 5, you'll get everything is 0. Okay. Basically, once you get 0, after that, all will be 0. Okay. So 0 by 0 is not defined for that reason, or if you don't want to deal with it, whatever it is. No term of a GP can be 0. Another way of saying is common ratio should not be 0, first term should not be 0. Okay. They can be 1, all numbers can be equal, but not 0. Okay. Then also, in fact, if all numbers are equal to also AP, it is also GP. You can tell it is an AP with common difference 0. You can also tell it is a GP with common ratio 1. Anyway. If ratio of consecutive numbers are equal and it then it is called GP, it is called R. So if you take first time as A, the second time will be R times first time. So it will be AR, next it will be AR square, AR cube, AR power 4, so on. One more thing, we studied in AP that the sum of these two is same as sum of these two, same as sum of these two. But in GP, the product of these two is same as product of these two, same as product of these two. When you have odd, even number of terms. What if you have odd number of terms? Let's say I'll take P5. In AP, sum of these two is equal to sum of these two equal to double of this. Whereas in GP, product of these two equal to product of these two equal to square of this. Okay, square of this middle. About odd and even. So now coming to this, okay. So you take the first term, keep on multiplying with R, you'll get other terms. You can observe now, first term, the second term has power 1, third term has power 2, fourth term has power 3, fifth term has power 4. So like that, nth term will be A into R power n minus 1. So this is a formula for nth term of a GP because of the pattern you can observe there. If you want sum of n terms, which is A plus AR plus AR square, so on up to AR power n minus 2 plus AR power n minus 1. There is a formula. How did we derive that? Here derivation is also important because whatever procedure we are going to use now for deriving the sum of n terms of a GP, later on for AGP also we are going to use same method. So it is better to know it. The method is multiply the common ratio on both sides. R into Sn will be AR plus AR square plus AR cube, AR power n minus 1 plus AR power n. So when you subtract these two, this and this will cancel, this will cancel. You will be left with first positive term, last negative term. You'll get Sn minus R into Sn is equal to A minus AR power n. When you take Sn common and divide, you'll get Sn into 1 minus R equal to A into 1 minus R power N. So sum of N terms is A into 1 minus R power N by 1 minus R. You take minus common and minus common, A into R power N minus 1 by R minus 1. So both this one and this one, both are same. We just took minus common and both are applicable only when common ratio is not equal to 1. When common ratio is 1, it will be 0 by 0, it will be 0 by 0. We cannot use this. They will not be defined. What to do when common ratio is 1, we'll see. But when common ratio is not 1, it's a formula. Sometimes I've seen some in the school, some teachers or in some books, they tell when common ratio is less than 1, use this, more than 1, use this. But actually both are same, which one use doesn't matter. After all, a minus will come common and it doesn't matter. Okay. Now you know very well that when n is tending to infinity, R power n can tend to infinity, can tend to 1, can tend to 0, depends on the R value. Okay. Only when mod R is less than 1, that is between minus 1 to 1. Of course, 0 we don't include, but it's okay. then Sn equal to A by 1 minus R. Okay, mod R less than 1, but R should not be 0 anyway. Okay. Because a number which is between minus 1 to 1 power infinity will be a decreasing function, tends to 0 finally. We'll be left with A by 1 minus R. Then one may ask, what if common ratio is more than 1? So what is the answer? It will be infinity or minus infinity, depends on A value. Because if R is, let's say, 5, the quantity of the number is keep on increasing. Okay. So the nth term itself will become infinity, what to be called sum of n terms. And if A itself is negative, let's take minus 7 and keep on multiplying 5. The number quantity is increasing, but there's a minus. So when you add all of them, you'll get minus infinity. So when common ratio is not in this set,
sir, one doubt.
Yes, please.
Sir, yes, means if A is sir, if A is any positive number and R is negative, sir, then it will converge or diverge, sir?
No, even then it will diverge. Even then it will diverge. Okay. R is negative.
Means
that
if
too...
we take sir, means if we take limit to infinity, it is undefined, no, sir. Means how we can say it will diverge,
okay,
or converge that
time. Let us take 7, keep on multiplying with minus 3. I'll get minus 21 plus 63 minus 189, like that. Right? Now, let us take whether it converges or whether limit exists or not, we'll talk about it, but let us see what happens. Let us imagine n is even and see what is happening. Every time you take n even, okay?
Yes.
Then this is a negative number. This total is a negative number. Your next two together will be a negative number. And the quantities are becoming bigger. Am I right?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Let us say you are taking odd number. And we're coming to this case. So when you take even, you are taking, answer is becoming minus infinity. No doubt, right?
Yeah. Yes, sir.
When you take odd number, let us see what happens. This is a positive number. This and the next together is a positive number. This and next together. I left one element. So total, it is even. Odd, but leaving this, it is even. If this sum is positive, this sum is positive, next sum is positive, and all are becoming bigger, right? So it will be tending to plus,
yes,
infinity.
Sir.
So what happens is when, yes, you put n equal to 1 lakh, answer will be very close to minus infinity. When n is 1 lakh 1, it will be close to plus infinity. Right? Okay.
Yes, sir.
So we don't say it is converging because it is, that means it is diverging because tending to infinity, but some may be tending to only plus infinity or some may be tending to only minus infinity, but this one is oscillating. Okay, so limit doesn't exist for this. So if you want,
yes,
S infinity, it is not even infinity, not even minus infinity. It is oscillating between them.
Yes.
Okay.
Understood. Thank you.
Okay. So where are we now? Yeah, so only when common ratio is between minus 1 to 1 except 0, we can use this formula, A by 1 minus R. So that's it. We are seeing nth term formula. Where is that? Sum of n terms in general and sum of n terms when n is becoming infinity. So I should say S infinity, or it is actually limit n tends to infinity Sn. Is this? Okay.
Sir?
Now, yes, please.
Sir, one doubt. Means if we take A equal to 1 and R equal to minus 1, sir, then it will tend to infinity or minus infinity or...
No. It will oscillate between only minus 1 and 1. All its ranges contains only two things. Okay. So we did not discuss about common ratio 1 net. Okay.
Yes.
This is common ratio not equal to 1. When common ratio is 1, in a sense, you don't need any formula. Why? Because, of course, you are talking about minus 1. I'm talking about 1, okay? Yeah, when you talk about minus 1 here, also we cannot neglect this, so... Wait. Anyway, this formula is for mod r less than 1, and r greater than 1 we discussed, r less than minus 1 we discussed what is happening. We are only talking about r equal to 1 versus minus 1, we'll talk about less. Coming to r equal to 1, what happens? We'll get a plus a plus a plus a, so on. It'll be any... If A is positive, it is becoming plus infinity. If A is negative, it is becoming minus infinity. Okay. Of course, when common ratio is minus 1, you will get a minus a plus a minus a plus a minus a, so on. Then what happens? Answer can be either 0 or a. Right?
Sir, it only can't be minus a, sir.
No, where is minus a? Not possible, no? If you take up to here a, up to here 0, up to here a, up to here minus. Okay, minus a is not. Even if it's the example that you took is 1 minus 1 plus 1 minus 1 plus 1 minus 1. Minus 1 doesn't come. Answer is either 0 or 1.
Yes.
If you start with minus 1 plus 1 and all, minus 1 plus 1 minus 1 plus 1, answer is either minus 1 or 0. Okay? Understood now. You cannot get minus 1 and 1.
Yes. Thank you.
When r is equal to 1, we don't need a formula because all terms are same. So if you want 20 terms, it will be 20. If you want 30 terms, it will be 30. You don't need a formula. So that's why generally we don't talk about r equal to 1. It's so simple. But otherwise, I wrote also. Okay. R equal to 1 implies sum of n terms is straight away n. Okay. So we have seen what is GP definition, what is the nth term. Sum of n terms formula, then common ratio is 1 and common ratio not equal to 1. Sum of infinite terms and common ratio in open interval minus 1 to 1 when it is not 0. Okay. Now, inserting geometric means, we have to discuss about that. Okay. Let us say I have A and B and some terms G1, G2, so on up to Gn. Some n numbers are kept between A and B so that we have total a series of n plus 2 terms and they are in GP. Then we say we inserted n arithmetic means between A and B. Now how to find these things? What is G1, what is G2, what is G3? Your first term is A and B is n plus 2th term. According to formula, it will be AR power n minus 1. That will give us the common ratio. Divide with A, you will get B by A is equal to R power n minus 1. And R is
AR power n plus 1.
Ah, n plus 1. Thank you. This is n plus 1. This is 1 by n plus 1. So the common ratio is this by this power 1 by n plus 1. Keep on multiplying with that, you will get. If somebody wants geometric mean 1, it is second term in the series, which is AR. We'll get A into B by A whole power 1 by n plus 1. If at all you want to write power of A, power of B separately, you are going to get A power n by n plus 1, B power 1 by n plus 1. Similarly, if I want G2, it is third term, which is AR square, A into B by A whole power 1 by n plus 1 whole square, which will be 2. When you simplify, we'll get A power n minus 1 by n plus 1, B power 2 by n plus 1. You can see some of the powers is 1 only will come. Okay, here also some of the powers is 1. So if you want kth geometric mean, which is k plus 1th term, which is AR power k, which is A into B by A whole power K by N plus 1. When you simplify, you'll get A power N plus 1 minus K by N plus 1 and B power K by N plus 1. Okay. Now somebody may say, in arithmetic progression, you told us that we can use a section formula, right? And get all those things. If somebody wants second arithmetic mean, you will take two parts here and n minus one parts here and say 2 into this plus n minus 1 into this by this. What will you say like that in geometric progression?
We multiply, that's it.
We'll multiply. What do you mean by multiply?
means for a division means for division we'll take nth roots, sir, and for plus we'll take multiplication.
Yeah, it's okay. I would have said almost same thing. I can say I can convert GP to AP. You apply log everywhere.
You can apply GP log,
AP, na? Yeah, apply log and use section formula and remove it. So if you want, let us say log G2, then this is 2, this is n minus 1. So I have to write 2 into log B, log of this, plus n minus 1 into log A by n plus 1. Okay. Now what happens? This will become 2 here. This will become n minus 1. This will become power. Okay. In fact, even this, you can write it as an into b whole power 1 by n plus 1. This one, we can write it as a power n minus 2 into b square whole power 1 by n plus 1. This can be written as a power n plus 1 minus k into b power k whole power 1 by n plus 1. Okay, so it is not directly section formula. You can apply log, apply section formula and remove the log. You will get it because I have converted GP into AP by applying the log. Okay. If you feel that this log and all unnecessary, then just do this procedure. Or you can remember this formula, final formula. Either you can remember this, or you can remember this, or you can remember this. Or you can just remember that common ratio is B by A power 1 by N plus 1 and do it. Whatever it is, depends on the question. Is it okay about geometric progression?
Yes, sir.
So far in GP, anybody any doubts in the concept?
Yes.
Okay, even in GP, AR square, so on. In AP, we studied, you add a number, subtract a number, multiply with a number, divide with a number, AP will still remain AP. The common difference may change, first term may change, or may not change, the common difference. In GP, when you add a number, it will not be GP. For example, you take A plus 1, AR plus 1, AR square plus 1, AR cube plus 1. Okay? You take this by this, this by this, this by this, they are not same. When you take, you can understand easily, they are not coming same. Okay. So sometimes you will find this I'll give a simple question. 4 by 7 plus 44 by 77 and 444 by 777. This is the question I want. That's okay. This number. Sometimes you'll find, let's say, 44 by 7 square, 444 by 7 cube, 444 by 7 power 4. Okay? This is not a AGP. This is not AP, not GP, not AGP. Okay? Is it AP? No. Because this minus this is not C. It is not GP, obviously, because from here to here, I have to multiply 11 by 7. But from here to here, if I multiply 11, I will not get 444, I will get 484. And if I multiply 11, this will not come, something else will come. Okay, so it is not GP. It is not AGP because 1 by 7, 1 by 7 square, 1 by 7 cube are in AP, but 444, 444, they are not in GP. Then what is this? What is this? We will talk about later, but answer will come very easily. You take S here, multiply with 1 by 7, S by 7, the same method that you use for GP. You'll get 4 by 7 square, 44 by 7 cube, 444 by 7 power 4, so on. Now, when I subtract, what will come? S minus S by 7, you will get 4 by 7. From this, when you subtract, you'll get 40 by 7 square. From this, if I subtract this, I'll get 400 by 7 cube. From this, if I subtract this, I'll get 4000 by 7 power 4, so on. Mm-hmm. Except the first term, including the first term, are they in geometric progression now?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes. So we can find this answer and then divide with 6 by 7, we'll get. One may say the original series is not AP, not GP, not AGP. But when you do this thing, it is coming GP. Why it's coming? That is because it's actually GP plus a constant. we add some particular number, it is not AP, not GP, not AGP, but still we can find sum of n terms. Okay. For example, I'll add AP plus GP. Let us see what is that. I will take A plus capital A, A plus D plus capital AR, and A plus 2D plus capital AR square, so on. Okay. This is one term. This total is one term. This total is one term. There is no name for it, but it is possible to find sum of n terms. Why? I will add all these things separately. I'll get one answer. All these things one answer. One is AP formula. One is GP formula. Total, I'll get the answer. But the progression as such doesn't have a name, right? Okay. It is not that all the series that you have are like AP or GP. Okay. So anyway, coming back to this, the sum of n terms of this series can be found, but it is not any series. By adding a constant to a GP, it will not be any one of the known progressions as such. What if you multiply two GPs? No, multiply the number, then it's okay. Let us multiply the LAR square, so on. So in a GP, by adding a number, subtracting a number, it will not be GP. But if you multiply or divide with a number, it will be GP only. Same common ratio, only first term will change. What about when you take two APs? Let's say AAR, AR square is one AP. Capital A, capital AR, capital AR square is another AP, another GP. Sorry. This one GP, this one GP. When you multiply the corresponding terms, will they form GP?
Yes, sir. Yes. Sir.
Yes. First term will be small a into capital A, and the common ratio will be this common ratio to this common ratio. But when I add two GPs, will I get GP? Let us see that. Small a plus capital A, small AR plus capital AR, small AR square plus capital AR square. I don't think this by this is same as this by this. It is not. So, for a GP, add or subtract a number, it is not anything. Multiply the number, it is GP. Two GPs when you take, when you multiply them, it is always GP. But when you add them, it is not necessary. It may be. I'll tell you when. That is, this also has same common ratio, but first term is different. Then this will be small a plus capital A into smaller. This is small a plus capital A into small r square. Then it is GP. So if two GPs of same common ratio, if I add, I'll get a GP. If they're of different common ratio, most likely it is not a GP. Is it okay?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Two GPs I multiplied, I got GP. When you divide also, I'll get GP by the way. Small a by capital A. Small AR by capital AR. Small AR square by capital AR square. That is also GP. So two GPs. And one more thing. If some set of numbers are in GP, their reciprocals are also in GP. If A, AR, AR square is GP, 1 by A, 1 by AR, 1 by AR square, they are in GP. If there are questions where three terms are in GP, four terms are in GP, five terms are in GP, you have to solve the question. If three numbers are in GP, you can take A, AR, AR square. Better is you can take A by R, A and AR. So the solving will be easier sometimes. If they ask product of the numbers, it will be AQ. When you take five terms, it will be A by R square, A by R, A, AR, AR square. But if four terms, common ratio R doesn't look nice, we'll take R square. You have to take, can we take AR? Yes, we can take AR, we can take A by R, but we have to multiply, common ratio is not R, R square, it will be AR cube. This will be A by R cube. So if you say four terms are in GP, you can take like this. The product will come A power 4, but A is not any term in this series. And the common ratio is not R, it will be R square. If they wanted six terms, just put a r power 5 here and a by r power 5. So that is the questions where they tell three numbers and GP, five numbers and GP, four numbers and GP. You can take like this and it will be some use. Not only in GP sum of n terms, sometimes we may come across product of n terms. a into r into ar square into ar cube so on up to ar power n minus 1. Product of n terms, how to find this answer? There are two ways. Method one, a when I multiply, I'll get a power n. R when I multiply, I have to add the powers, which is 1 plus 2 plus 3 so on up to n minus 1. This is a power n. Sum of n minus 1 natural, not that n natural numbers, n minus 1 natural numbers is n minus 1 into n by 2. Now, this I can write a square r power n minus 1 whole power n by 2. This n, I wrote 2 into n by 2. This I took n by 2 outside. Okay. Now, I want to write this as a into ar power n minus 1 power n by 2. That is first term into last term power, not n, power n by 2. Why? I'll explain this another method. We take this as p, the product. Take same product, but everything in reverse order. Ar power n minus 1 here, ar power n minus 2 here. Here, ar square, here, ar, and here, a. When I multiply these two, what is p square will come, the product whole square. This is also a square power, a square r n minus 1. This also a square r n minus 1. This also, we will get a square r n minus 1. Same thing n times, so whole power n. When you divide with 2, that is exactly this. Another of saying, same thing is, this is one pair, this is another pair, this is another pair, like this will get n by 2 pairs. And each pair product is a square r n minus 1. Like that, n by 2 pairs I have to multiply, that's why power n by 2. If it is in AP, so we have to write, we have to add that many times, so we would have written into n by 2, n by 2 pairs. Now it is n by 2 pairs have to be multiplied, that's why power n by 2. Is it clear? Power of n terms of a GP? Is it product of n terms of a GP?
Yes.
Okay. And already we mentioned that if take GP and apply log, you'll get AP. Or you take AP and take A power first term, A power second term, A power third term of AP is what you get will be GP. Let me see if we missed something, just in case. Almost time is up, I'm going to stop it. Okay, geometric progression definition is given. Non-zero numbers is clearly mentioned. We talked about sum of n terms. Yeah, that's it. Only one point I missed indirectly. Some more points which are not there also I covered maybe. You take a GP, square all the numbers will get GP. Cube all the elements will get GP. So when you do power k for all of them, you take a power k, r whole power k, r square whole power k. That's also a GP with the common ratio. If earlier r, now it will be r power k. Okay. Of course, we discussed talking about multiplying two GPs. Like that, you can multiply many GPs. That is, power k means you multiply k such GPs. That's all. You multiply two or three GPs correspondent times also, it will be a GP. Okay. So tomorrow I'll discuss past year mains questions, definitely at least up to 20, if at all you have doubts. If not, we'll continue doing some more questions on geometric progressions. If time is there, we'll start harmonic progression. All right. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.